Today we have a multiple regression practical part, and thereafter we have a polynomial regression. First, I would like to tell you all once again what I mean by the linear regression. In the linear regression, there would be one independent variable, one dependent variable. That part we have seen. In the linear regression, the line is supported by the y equal to mx plus a. But in the case of the multiple regression, we have many independent variables, so more than one independent variables we have, that is known as the multiple linear regression. So multiple linear regression, or we can say the multiple regression, basically it is a method or a technique that is used to define that you can have the more than one independent variable to predict your result, to predict your outcomes. That is the point we have to understand. So over the screen you can see we have a simple linear regression which defines the equations y equal to v0 plus v1 x1. So what you are observing, this equation is similar to straight line equations y equal to mx plus c, which defines that we have a one independent and other one is a one dependent variable. But in the case of the multiple linear regression, you can easily observe over here we have the multiple independent variables, and those variables are recognized by the x1, x2 and so on, so xn. So when we have the multiple independent variables, and along with respectively, it has own coefficient. So coefficient is recognized by the b1 and b2, b and so on, so bn, xn. And x1, x2, xn are the independent variables, and while b1, b2 and up to bn, these are the respective coefficient of the each and every independent variables. That is the point. And b0 is our intersection point we can have. So y equal to v0 plus v1 x1 plus b2 x2 plus b3 x3 plus b4 x4 and so on, so bn xn. This is our simple equation by which we can understand. That is an important point we have to understand. So from this point, we have to start our practical parts properly. So what I did over here, I used a data set, and I will show the demonstration why, which is the data set I'm using. So y equal to m1 x1 plus m2 x2 and plus c. So this is simple equations which defines that we have a two independent variable. Those are recognized by the x1 x2 name. While m1 m2 are the coefficient of the x1 x2 respectively, and c, it is a intersection point of the y, as we know. So if we have the multiple of n number of the independent variables, so the equation can be write like the y equal to m1 x1 plus m2 x2 plus m3 x3 and so on, so mn xn plus c. So multiple regression is just like a linear regression, but with more than one independent values we can have. So meaning that we try to predict our values based on the two or more independent variables. Based on two or more independent variables. So I can write over here properly independent variables. So what we have to do, rather than the understanding this concept theoretically, it's a better idea to understand this concept with the practical part. So the picture, the idea, the concept will be clear to all in summarized way. So what I'm using, I'm showing the practical part over here with the help of the Python libraries. So I'm using the some Python libraries. First one, we have the pandas library. So with help of the pandas libraries, I'm used to represent the my information, the data frame. So I have to use this library, that is the pandas library. So PD and P are the object. You can give your own names, no issue. So pandas library I'm using, numpy library I'm using, and sklearn library I'm using, and I'm calling the linear model over here. And from the sklearn package, I'm using the model selection class where we have to use, we have to import the train underscore test underscore split method to bifurcate or to divide data into two parts. One is the training data and testing data. So let me call all these files. Let me run this code in front of you, then information will be visible to all properly. After this point, in between the execution is going on. So in between, let me understand or let me explain what is the data set I'm using. So what I'm using, I'm just reading the my data set or my data in form of the CSV format. I'm reading through the read underscore CSV method. And this read CSV method will be the part of the pandas library. So I have to use a variable that is a PD variable by which I can access this method. So what I need to pass over, I need to pass the data file which contains the cars.csv. Car.csv is a data set name, and how to create all the things as we have already discussed. So I am importing this CSV file over the from the internet, and I'm using same file over here to show the demonstration of the multiple regression, because it contains the many attributes name. So I need to choose the attributes name which could be the independent or which could be the dependent variable. So df is my variable which is just to keep the all the rows and columns values of the cars.csv data set. So I'm printing over here. So let me execute this code in front of you and let me choose. Yes, now it is visible to all, and the diagram is visible to all, or the model data set information is visible to all.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so here what you are observing, car is a name of the model. So that is a car model. We have the various models I'm listed over here. Model, we have the different models. So what is the car name we have? It is manufacturer, it is brand name we have, and its model we have respectively its model. And definitely we're talking about the some mechanical engineering aspect. A car will require to imagine the CO2, that carbon dioxide. It depends on the volume and weight. So what is the weight of the car and what is the volume of the car? Just like the, as we know, the carbon cube cc, what is cc of the car? So bike, we have the 65 cc bike. In earlier days it was launched. Now we have a 150 cc bike. Now we have the different kind of the cc bike, 170, 175, 200 cc bike. So this is particularly carbon cubic, and that is defined, that is what is the volume of the car we have and what is the weight of the car or vehicle we have. Based on this point, the CO2 will be generated after emission. So after emission, the CO2 will be generated. So car model cannot be independent or could be independent variable. But out of these four or five attributes, car, model, volume, and weight, and CO2, CO2 is our dependent variable, which will be dependent on the two important attributes. One is a model and volume and weight and car. So we have to decide. Volume and weights are the two independent variable that defines the dependency will be of the CO2. So CO2, our attribute name or attribute which will depend on the volume and weight only. CO2 will not be depend on the model. CO2 will not be depend on the car, because we are talking about the functionality part. So if car name I'm changing, I'm car model name I'm also changing. So CO2 generation will not be depend. CO2 generation will be depend on the what is the volume and what is the weight of the vehicle or car I have. That is the point we have to understand. So this is the point from which we have to choose the appropriate independent variable name. Now it is clear to all right now? Yes, tell me right now. Any doubt so far?
Yes, sir.
No. Okay, so before choosing the appropriate to independent variable and dependent variable, we have to understand the problem. So after choosing this point, let us move to the next sentence. What we have, by choosing x and y, we are getting the values of the independent and dependent variables. So this code, now you are able to see over here, there's a filter code. Because many times I have written this code and I amended so many times this code in front of the students. So now you are just able to see the filter code over here, which is already written by the comment by me many times. So whenever you have any doubts, you can ask me. So what I'm choosing? I'm choosing the two variables, one is x and y. So x will be the dependent independent variable, y will be the dependent variable. So by choosing the x, y, we are getting the values of the independent dependent variable. So weight and volume would be your independent variable. So weight and volume will be your independent variable, while dependent variable would be only one. So I'm repeating once again, as per the multiple regression definition, many dependent variable could be, more than one dependent variable could be, while one dependent variable will be. So independent variable could be more than one, that is the point. So here we have the two independent variables, which means we are talking about the multiple regression. So x and y I'm choosing over here, and so weight and volume I need to pass over here. So rather than the passing single attribute name, I can pass the multiple attribute names over here. And what is the name of the other attributes? Weight and volume, or you can write the volume or weight, it's your choice. Next we have the CO2. So keep in mind, first we need to pass the weight, and other we are passing the volume. That is a sequence we have to understand. And X will contain all the data of the these weight and volume as in respectively followed by the columns. And we have the Y, we have this one. So I'm executing this code in front of you, so the data will be visible to all. So now you can see, observe over here, we are not having the limited amount of data. We have the total number of the rows 36, 0 to 35. You can easily see, observe over here. You can easily see how many rows and how many columns we have. Definitely we have the 5 columns, but while you can observe, we have the 36 rows. So 36 data we have and indexed of rows indexed by the 0 to 35. So 0 to 35 we have. So now you can easily see. And next we have chosen the CO2. CO2 is what? That is the carbon dioxide, which is to be emitted by the or generated by the weight and volumes. So here we have the 0 to 35. So total 36 we have. So this index, this column belongs to the CO2 we have also. After this point, after executing this code in front of you, now I'm executing this code in front of you once again. Now, next we have, let us print only the 5 data from the X and Y. What is X? X is independent variables and Y is a dependent variable. So if I need to see the total number of the or two top 5 records, total, how I can say, out of the my total records, I'm able to see only top 5 records. So what is syntax? Just use the add command, add function. So with the add function, we can able to see the top 5 records. And reversely, you can see the tell command or tell function by which you can able to see the last or bottom 5 records. So now you will able to see 0 to 4. Now you're able to see, now same, we are able to see 0. So these are what, this is our data representation I'm showing over here. So let me execute this code in front of you. Now this code is executed. Some student asked me a question, sir, how we can determine what is the total number of the columns we have? Because after some times we have observed that now my code is crawled. So rather than the moving to the back or just the previous cells, it's a better idea to, can we see the how many columns we have? So it's a better idea. Just use the columns variable. This helps the columns variable, and what is the name of the our variable in which our entire data set is stored, followed by the pandas libraries. So by using the columns variable, we can see. So with the help of this command, you can able to see. So let me execute this code in front of you. Now you can able to see. So car is our one attribute, model is one attribute, for volume, weight, and CO2 is our attributes by which we are able to see all the data over here. Just before moving to the next part, just you have any doubts, so you can ask me right now. Can anyone tell me right now any doubts so far? Anyone who needs to ask any question right now, so please you can ask. Yes, tell me right now. Any doubt so far?
No, sir.
Okay. So it is time to split our data into the training and testing data. So now what we have to do? Now it is time to build the model. So what is the first step we have covered? We have covered the gathering the data. In our data, there is no null values available, so we are having the perfect data. So no need to prepare the more data properly, so no need to remove the necessary data points. So it is time to build our model. So before building the model, let us use the training data set. So what is the command by which we can do? So we are using the train underscore test underscore split method to filter our data two parts, one is training data and testing data. So here you can say me right now, what is the total size or what is the percentage I must keep over here for testing data size? Can anyone tell me right now? Can anyone tell me? What is the percentage of the testing data I must have?
So 20.
So 20 is already here, but if you want to do some amendment, then you can do. You can take the any size of the training testing data, testing data. So you have to pass the testing size over here. So 20 we have already taken previously, but if you want to amend and you want to change, then you can change the size of testing. Just please tell me right now. You can take 15, 20, 10, or 20, 25, 40, 45, 50. You can take any size. Now tell me, can you change the values? What is the percentage I must keep over here for testing data? Yes, tell me.
Say 30.
Okay, 30. So as per the students, I'm using a 30. So 30, 03 or 0.30, it doesn't mean. So we are having same sense. So I'm changing the my testing data size, that is 30%. I'm random state. You can pass any integer value, 0 to any integer value you can pass. It is optional. So random state, if you are not using, then it will automatically do the random. But if you are passing expertly, then you can pass the random state attribute or parameter. For this function, you can pass any integer value, 0 to any n value. So here I'm printing the training data values, what will be filtered out over here. Testing data and training data of the our independent variable and dependent variable we can do. So now our result will be changed over here, because now we have changed our 20% to 30% over here. So let me execute this code and let us see what we are getting. So what is the 30% of the total 36? You can observe over here, 36 of the 30%, it will around approx 10 to 11, 10 to 11. So testing size will be the 10 to 11 data out of 36. Okay, so now you can see, this is our total data we are able to see. 4, 26, 18, 22, 17, 23, 15, 27, 13, and 33, and 5. So this is our data which defines that the now we have a testing data. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So 11 is the total size of the testing data which is coming from the our test underscore, training underscore test underscore split method. So out of 36 data, we have a 11 data that belong to testing data. After this point, we have to build the, our model. So that is the point we have to understand, building the model. So building the model is a more important step in which we have to use. So what you are using, we are using the linear regression method only, a class only over here. Why I'm not calling the multiple linear regression or any kind of the regression model? So in the Python, no function exists multiple linear regression, multiple regression, and polynomial function, no function is exist. With help of the linear regression, you have to determine, you have to design your regression model. That is a point you have to understand. So if you have any question regarding this point, just so sir, we have a multiple regression model function or multi polynomial regression function model. No, we don't have. We have to use the linear regression class, linear regression model over here. So based on this model, our output will be generated properly. So let us understand all the things what we are doing. So sklearn.linear model and linear regression I'm calling over here. I'm just using only. So what is my base model over here? My base model is linear regression. I'm creating the object, that is instantiation object. So creating the model. What I change over here, rather than changing the my model, I can write the model variable name over here. Or you can say the my model or whatever the name you want to give, you can give. So I have given the name over here, only the model. So rather than the my model too, I'm changing its variable name model only. If you want to do any change, if you want to give any name, then you can give. Now I'm creating the object of the linear regression model. So I'm creating the over here. So what I'm doing, I'm just creating the linear regression class objects over here through the our linear regression class. So this point I'm creating. Now, Model should be fit towards the training data. So definitely what we have to pass, we have to pass the two important variables as in a parameter of the fit function, that is a training, X training and Y training. So now we have already got our size of the data. We have already passed the, we have already got all the data, all the variables, all the information inside the training, Y training and X training variable, which keeps the training data. So training data set, or that is the mean which is required to fit the model. So fitting the model means we are building the model as per the training data. So what I'm doing, what is my name, my model name? So I given the my model name, that is only the model, because I've changed over here. Now I'm printing this message over here, our model is built. So now I can say, I'm just changing something. Now we have built the model, okay. So after building the my model, this message will be displayed bottom side. So what I'm doing, I'm using the training data, which is pulling by the multiple independent variables. That is the point you have to understand. So by using the training data set, I'm fitting the my model. So my model will fit towards the training data, and which keeps the multiple independent variable in form of the x-axis. So definitely what I'm doing here, I'm just building the multiple regression. Okay, so now let me execute this code, and now I'm executing this code. So now I got a message, we have built the model. Now it is clear to all right now, or any doubt over here? So please you can ask me right now. Yes, tell me, any doubt so far?
No, sir.
So any doubt in the course, so you can ask me anytime, so we can discuss the particular line whenever you are feeling any problem.
No, sir.
Okay, so after building the model, now it's time to predict the model. So what is the parameter I can use to predict the my model? So I can predict the my model based on the testing data. So why I have to use the testing data, x-test? Because based on the testing data, I can predict the my model. So as a independent variables, so because my predicted data, that is my prediction of the our outcomes will be depend on the predicted information. So predicted information, the testing data, we have stored to the x-test format. So for predicting the model, we have to choose the predict method, and for this using, we have to use the testing data. What is the name of the my variable? Model only. So I have to use the model variable, model object variable, by which I can use the predict method, in which I need to pass the x-text variable, which gives the testing data set, and the testing data set of independent values. Okay. So by prediction is what? By prediction is the predicted values. By prediction means which is a prediction by predicted values of the my by prediction values of the my x text. What is the point? The x text will contain the weight and volume. So towards the testing data, predict method will predict the values, and the y prediction will keep the all the values of the testing database information, that is the independent variable we have. So by prediction will keep the or hold the predicted data, and y test is what? That is the actual data, which will represent the actual data, and towards, I can write over here for your betterment, towards the x test. This is a little bit different, you have to understand. By prediction we have, and by test I'm printing over here. So let me show the my proof. So by prediction, I am indicating the 100. What is actual values? What is actual values? 105. But it is showing the 100 only. And by prediction, giving the value 105, but actual value was 104. Because total prediction, total testing data, I have the 10. So this is the 4, 26, 18, 22, 17. This is about, this is nothing. This is the row index values. 4, 26, 18, 22, 17, 23, 15, 27, 13, 23, and 5 is the index values, row index values. while 105, 104, 104, 19, and 104 again we have, this is our testing values. And while the hold values we have over here, so I can write over here for a betterment, predicted values. Okay. The predicted values, and this is what, this is known as the actual values. This is the actual values of what? Testing data. Let me show the once again. Now this is the predicted values I'm getting, and this is the actual values. So actual values we are getting over here. So we are getting all the things. Yes, right now. Tell me any doubt so far. Yes, tell me right now any doubt so far you have.
No, sir.
No, sir.
Okay. So after this point, the question should have in our mind. So now we have built the model and we have predicted our model. So predicting the CO2 emission of a car where the weight is, I'm giving the weight 6,000 kg and volume is, just I'm taking the only 1,000. Thank you. Okay. And putting new values to the to get the value. So 6,000 I can put over here. I'm remembering to all the ones again. We have used the weight first, while volume we have taken as a second parameter before defining a thing. Just let me show them and proof. This is a point. By choosing the x and y variables, what I have used a weight as a first parameter and volume was the second parameter. Okay, so this is a point. Now, so I've changed something over here as according to my questions. So now, predicted CO2 is what? This is our new values. So if I need to pass any information, so my prediction will come over here. But if you want to do pass any new value, then you can pass. So my model is, this is my multiple iteration regression model, which is built by me over here. And that model is just built for only to predict the CO2 based on the weight and volume. So what is my variable name? My variable name is model over here. So I'm changing my variable name to my model to model only. So I'm using the same predictive method over here, in which I'm passing the two parameters. One is the weight, another one is the volume. So after passing this value and predicted CO2 is a new variable which holds the outcomes or response. Let me execute this code in front of you and let me check what you're getting. So this is printing the thing that is the 177.473. This is what, this is even known as the predictive CO2 which will be generated over here. So definitely based on our data set, the my model is built. It doesn't mean the we are using the actual data, we are using the any just hypothetical data only. So but our model is built based on our data set. So if you are having the actual data set, real life now, real time data set, and that is a good program, a good project we can say. But you are using only 10 bit or rough data, that will be no sense. So this is only the tentative data I'm using only for explaining purpose. But if you are working on the real project or real data set, then your outcomes will be more crisp and clear, to close to the better result. So while building any project, while building any model, just I suggest to all the students, please, you can use a real data set. And data set you can download from the internet or various places. Everywhere data sets are available. From the data set, you have to identify which could be the independent variable, which could be dependent variable. So you have to design your model towards the data set requirement or your problem. So this is the point. So now this is a prediction, we can get it. So after this point, if we need to evaluate the model, or we need to measure our model. So now this is the point I can write over here. It is time to evaluate the model. if we need to evaluate the model or to check, or we can say to check the performance of the model, what we can do, you just need to use the various thing. So from the sklearn package, from the matrix library, I need to create a variable result. A result, you can take any variable name, whatever you want to take. I have taken the name over here, result. So this result is an object which used to access the method which is inside in the matrix class. So mean absolute error I can use with help of the result object. I can use the method name, that is a mean underscore absolute error. So I can use the absolute error. So what I need to pass over here, I need to pass the two variable. One is a predicting variable, another one is a testing variable. So I'm using the round function. The round function till two will maintain. If you're not using round function, so the decimal values more than the 10 decimal values or more than 12 value decimal value, it will display. So if you want to concise, or if you want to provide the constraint to the our route result as a two decimal, then you can use a round function. YB you can do, and just you need to pass the two, so you can do. Mean square error we can do, but what we have to do, we have to use a mean square error. I'm using another measurement criteria I'm taking over here. It's optional, but if you want to do, then you can use it. That is R2 score. So R2 score is what? R2 score is a name of the our parameter, but if you want to use, then you can use, else you can use. So I can read tell this about later on. First let me explain the what we are getting as a mean square absolute error, or what we are getting the mean square error. Let me execute this code. We are getting the mean absolute error, that is a 5.91, while mean square error we are getting the 41.51. So we have the minimum number of the mean square error, minimum number of the absolute error, then we are, say our model is perfect, our prediction is going to the perfect. Why test is just actual testing. By prediction is the predicted values of the our tested part. So the point you can observe were the result which are coming, which are showing by the dependent variable followed by the testing and predicted part. So now we have a very minimum gap. So now you can easily see the prediction, we are predicting variable we are getting 100, but actual value is 0104. So the 405 is the first one. So only the 5 values we are getting. This is just only the 5. 107 where 4 is the predictive values and actual value is 104. So again, 3 gaps we have. So here we have the minimum number of the gaps. So our definitely the mean square error, mean absolute error will provide the minimum error. But when we have the use gaps, so definitely the your mean square error and mean absolute error will give the more and more values. And next we have the next parameter for evaluating the model. We have the R2 score. Time to time we will see all the things, but I am telling to all the people over here just only this one right now. So R2 score we can see, observe over here. So what is R2 score? R2 score is another measurement criteria which defines that you are using R2 square to refers to the coefficient of the determination. And this parameter, this function or this R2 square measurement criteria, which tells the how well the unknown sample will be predicted to our model. So how well the unknown samples means we have taken the randomly data, we have taken the randomly data to measure our model. So if I choosing the any random data, so the data is unknown, we can say unknown sample. So how unknown samples are predict the our model in better way. So if you are getting the possible outcomes as a 1, if you are getting the possible outcome as a 1, so we can say we are getting the 100% perfect model. We are getting the 100% perfect model. But if you are getting the negative values or positive values, so we can say our model showing the performance negative pattern or our positive pattern. So with help of the R2 score we can do. So R2 score is just nothing, from the our selected sample data it will decide how the model will predict the our model in better way. So this is also only the prediction will be shown by the R2 score. So R2 square, we can say the R2 square is the name of the point. So R2, basically it is not R2 square, I can speak over here, R square actually. So R square. So R square, our what is square, score parameter, which describes nothing, is describe the only the our prediction followed by the unknown sample of testing data we are choosing, because we are from the train underscore test underscore spin method, we are selecting the data as a randomly. So if you are choosing the randomly data, so if you are getting the values 1.0 something or close to the 1.0, it means our model is too much perfect. That is the point. So from this parameter we can decide if we are not able to check the accuracy. So linear regression, and we're talking about the our other parameters, if accuracy score parameter is not working, then you can use the R squared score parameter by which you can check. So let me show this proof in front of you. And unlike the mean absolute error, mean square error, you have to use the R2 score method name, and that is also part of the metric classes. So now we are getting the negative 0.49. So this is just value we are getting over here. So it depends upon your model, if it depends upon your data set choosing. This value could be negative, this value could be positive. But if you are getting the positive value, that is 1.0, it means our model is 100% accurate. And this tells. So this is a simple thing we have discussed. So this is the idea about the multiple linear regression, as I'm shown by the other two parts, you can see observable. Just tell me right now. So far, any doubt?